Good morning, children. Today we are going to begin with the first chapter of history, tracing changes through 1,000 years. We are going back to history from 1,000 years we are taking or we are learning today. Okay. So now I am showing you a picture here. Can you identify what picture it is? Any idea? What does it look like? Now can you see any changes? Can you identify? This is South India. You can find the South India and this is the Indian Ocean and Sri Lanka. Is it the map? Is it the way we are learning now? Okay, in your textbooks you have map, India map. See the shape of India and Indian Ocean, Sri Lanka. Okay, but here it is given this part as actually this is actual map in our textbooks we are learning. Okay, so here we know South India and Indian Ocean lies on the south, but in this map Indian Ocean is shown on the north. Why it happened or why it is like that? Okay, so here we will study. This is the first map and here we have the second map. This is the second map, almost look like the present day map pointing in the our modern India. Okay, almost looks the same. Okay, slight changes are there, but almost in the looking like our India map only. Okay, so first and the second maps, these two maps we are going to discuss with. Okay, so what differences we are finding out in these two maps? Okay, first map, we know that many years before it was made. It was made about 1154 CE. Okay, 1154 CE, the first map was made in 1154 CE by the Arab geographer, okay, Al-Idrisi. He was an Arabian geographer. Al-Idrisi made the first map. Okay, it was made in 1154 CE. So here the section reproduced here is a detail of the Indian subcontinent from his large map of the world, and it is only a portion. What the picture, first picture you have seen, is only a portion of the world map. Only India, part of India is taken here. Part of India is shown here. But the second map, which was made in 1720s, okay, 1720s, you can see the differences. How many years differences? 1720s by the French cartographer. Who is a cartographer? He is a person who makes maps. Cartographer is a person who makes maps. So a French cartographer made the second map. That is, we can find out the second map is almost similar to our India map. Okay, the present day India map. Now we know that we have modern technology, the satellite images and all. We can take the whole earth. Okay, so that absolute or exact map of India or world we can find out in the satellite pictures. Okay, but earlier by this period in 1720s or early, it was not available. This much technology was not developed, so people were not able to make extra map of India or the world. So here we know the second map, which was produced in 1720s by a French cartographer. These both are different. Okay, much different. We can find out they are the same area even though. Okay, India map only is shown here. Both are India map. Same area or region is shown here, but there are differences. In Al-Idrisi's map, we can find the South India where we expect to find North India. Okay, and Sri Lanka, it is an island on the top. But in the original map of India, real map of India, South India is shown south, and but in the map it is shown in the north. Indian Ocean is shown in the north, but actually Indian Ocean comes in the south. Also island Sri Lanka, that is south of India. Okay, in the map it is shown on the top. Okay, so in the map also place names are shown. Place names are written in Arabic language. Many place, all the place names are also shown in the Arabic language here, but in the second map it is all written in English. Also some names, particular names which were also written in a different spellings, also in a different way, also different pronunciation also. We know that Kanauj, which was an important trade center in the ancient period and even the medieval period also. Okay, so Kanauj, the spelling of Kanauj in Uttar Pradesh is spelled in a different way. Okay, and also about the first map was made, the second map was made almost 600 years after. Okay, during which the time information about the subcontinent also has changed. Many informations about the Indian subcontinent also changed. So here this map seems more familiar to us in the second map. Okay, the first map we may not be able to understand as we are studying the modern map of India. Second map is much similar to in the present day map which we are learning. Okay, so that in the second map also we can find coastal areas, all the coastal areas which is on the seashore are clearly marked. Okay, all particular regions are marked, the place names are also marked. Okay, so the second map we know that which was made in 1720s, this was largely used by the European sailors also. Okay, so the second map they used, European sailors for traveling to India, they used this map. With the help of this map they were easy to come to India also. So here all these white the differences we can find when we learn about the ancient maps, old maps also. Okay, by the these people make such kind of differences. Now we know that when historians read documents about the ancient documents or maps and a textbook texts from ancient period or past, they are very sensitive to different historical backgrounds, like the contexts in which information about the past was produced. We know that especially particular terminology, what was the terms or place names also even changed now. We know that in the modern world also, we are in the modern era when we are living also, we change the names of places also. Chennai was known as Madras. Okay, Mumbai was known as Bombay. Like that many changes. So that in the modern textbooks we can find Mumbai instead of Bombay. But in the history textbooks when we are studying about the during the Britishers period, it was written Madras, Bombay, etc. Okay, like that in the medieval period or modern period or even the ancient period also, place name changes, some terminology also changes. The name of our country has gone through many changes that we will study tomorrow in the next session about the new and old terminologies.